Hey guys, Craig from Accelerate Auto Electrics and Off Grid Touring here, and today we're going to show you through this one heck of a build on this big white armadillo. You can pretty obviously see why it's called that. Come check it out. Awesome build. Let's get into it. Alrighty guys, so this is where all the magic is happening in this one. So essentially what we have done here is recreated a caravan system. So these customers, about end of last year, we decked out their Lotus with pretty much this exact same system. So we had the 6 solar panels on top, we had the 600 amp hours of lithium, and all of the charging gear, 2600 watt inverter, etc. So I'll run through all that in detail here, but the whole idea of what we've done here in the truck is so that it can complement the caravan system. So I'll run through a bit more detail later, but essentially 600 amp hour system in the truck, identical 600 amp hour system in the caravan, so that if they're using one more than the other, normally the caravan more than the truck, they can transfer all of this power across, essentially giving them a 1200 amp hour battery system and over 2200 watts of solar. So it really is then literally a house on wheels. It's nearly the same size as an off-grid system, it's a small house. So it's really going to be just the ultimate setup for these guys. So in terms of the inverter, so typically if you're doing like an inverter install back of a ute, the AC transfer function, I guess, isn't really completely necessary, but we have wired it up in the back of this canopy so it works. So what that means is that if they do find themselves, for whatever reason, low on power, and they pull into a caravan park overnight, not only can they plug their caravan in and obviously run all of their appliances through mains without having to touch anything in the caravan, they do it in the truck too. So there's actually, I'll show you on the back in a second, we've actually got a 15 amp mains inlet at the back of the truck, same as you would in a caravan, so you can just plug the truck into mains power or shore power, and it's going to power all of the 240 volt accessories and everything in here, as well as obviously charge these batteries up at the same time. So I'll start with basics, batteries, obviously Enerdrive, BTEC, lithium's been around for ages, obviously tried, tested, proven, and very safe. They have the built-in Bluetooth battery monitoring. However, obviously that's null and void because we've got this ePro monitor installed actually inside the cab, which I'll show you as part of our little electrical board in the cab in a second. What you need to know for now, 600 amp hours of lithium is going to get these guys running all their appliances for a very long time. Okay, so the Enerdrive DC-DC charger, same one in this as there is in their van. What that does is convert the power supplied by the truck's alternator. Keep in mind the 24 volt alternator on these, which these Enerdrive DC-DCs can take, and converts it down to 12 volt power for the batteries in here and the van through its own separate DC-DC. So that's its primary function, is to charge these auxiliary truck batteries and the caravan batteries by its own DC-DC while you're driving, while you're in motion. Now, the solar input side of the DC-DCs, something we get asked really often, why don't we just run the roof-mounted solar through the DC-DCs? In this case, there's two reasons. First reason is the 40 amps isn't quite enough. We've got more than 40 amps worth of solar on the roof, so we obviously need a bigger regulator. Second reason is that if you have solar through that, you're only getting one charge source at a time. So you're only getting either 40 amps from the car or theoretically, you know, if you had 40 amps from solar. So that's the only one source at a time. If we run a separate solar regulator, separate DC-DC, what that allows is for us to get both lots of charge at the same time and cram it into the batteries in both the van and the truck. At the moment, we had the solar pumping at over 50 amps yesterday while it was nice and sunny on the truck. So we're getting that 50 amps combined with the 40 amps from the DC-DC. So this is getting charged at 90 amps while you're driving, and actually so is the caravan. We're actually getting about 180 amps worth of charge from solar and DC at once, going into both systems to really get this cranking and get them the quickest charge possible. The Morningstar TriStar 60 amp solar regulator. Now the ones we've used are just the PWM version. Lots of controversy out there in regards to MPPT versus PWM, etc., etc. Now, in a high voltage panel situation, house panels, that sort of stuff, yeah, massive difference between the two. Can definitely understand the theory there. When we're talking about automotive voltage panels, so say, you know, 20 volt, 18, 20 volt panels, there's actually very, very minimal difference in efficiency between an MPPT and a PWM in a real world scenario. So that's one reason. Second reason are they're cheaper. Third reason is these Morningstar TriStars are just bulletproof. So the number one thing for this customer, obviously doing remote travel, is reliability, and didn't want to take any chances, only wanted to use tried, tested and proven products. That's exactly why I've kept it really simple and we've gone with the Morningstar TriStar solar eggs. They've been around forever. Yes, there's probably some, you know, slightly more efficient controllers out there, but to be honest, in terms of just bulletproof reliability, they're really no-brainer. Obviously, Enerdrive 60 amp 240 volt charger. Yeah, they do make bigger chargers. To be honest, there's not really any need. Obviously, the whole idea of this system coupled with the caravan system is that there's just no need to have a super duper fast 240 charge. So obviously 600 amp hours of lithium, you do the math, 10 hours to charge from empty to full. Truth is, if you find yourself parked up at a caravan park, you're normally there for more than 10 hours anyway. So yes, can go bigger if you like. If your needs, you know, you want a bigger charge and a problem, for this setup here, there's just no need to go bigger or flasher. Simple, proven, reliable, and it just works. As you can see too, something I haven't really spoken about much in other videos, which I'll just mention quickly now, Enerdrive battery guards. But we use them in all of our off-grid systems for a very important reason. Yes, the batteries themselves have a built-in battery management system which offers all those protections over current, short circuit, all that sort of jazz. But for reliability, for simplicity, and for safety, these Enerdrive 200 amp battery guards are like, they only cost a couple hundred bucks. To be honest, they are really good, cheap insurance against your really expensive batteries. So in here too, obviously we've kept everything, like I mentioned before, reliability and simplicity for this build was absolute key. So we've kept everything honestly as basic and as user-friendly and as easily maintained as possible. So we've gone to the effort to put obviously the big main fuse block assembly up there, super easy to see, super easy to take the cover off and reach if anything ever was happen. You can probably also see here we've got a drop down MSA fridge side. This is the 95 litre and obviously the 95 litre Dometic CFX dual zone fridge freezer. Now this one's in this little battery compartment because it fits in here really nicely, but obviously if they want to leave the caravan somewhere and go just in the truck for the day, they now have the option of keeping everything super nice and cool in here. You got your locking mechanism here, release latch here, this then just slides out and drops down. Nice and simple. Easy to get all of your cold beers out of. In terms of lighting for this canopy, guys, so it's split into four sections of this big white armadillo. So what we've done in each section, I've put two of these meter long hardcore strip lights. So they are three color, they're tri-color. So you have your white, obviously your nice bright white light, pretty straightforward. You then have your amber. So click of the button. Oop, that was already on, was an amber. So the amber obviously gives you a bug-free time. So the amber light doesn't attract bugs like the bright white does. And then the third color is the combo. So it's like a white amber combination for that more of a warm white. They're also fully dimmable. So if you don't like things too bright, then you can just tap a button and dim them down just a little. So now we're at the rump of this big white armadillo. And we have got, as I sort of mentioned before, the 240 volt inlet. So this is for plugging your mains from mains power, shore power, your house, or wherever you are that you want to plug it into. Charge the batteries and run the 240 in the truck. Plugs into this one here, same as your caravan. So pretty straightforward, it works exactly the same as your caravan. Plug it in, don't press any buttons. The automatic transfer function of the Enerdrive inverter automatically swaparoos the power around and makes it work. So the other side here. This one's not another inlet, it's actually an outlet. So beauty about this one is that obviously we're gonna turn the inverter switch on, which I'll show you in a sec. Turn the inverter switch on, allows power through to here. So obviously working the back of the truck, doing whatever, if you have a little table with induction cooker or whatever you want, you can set it all up, plug it into here, the main rear outlet. This one's not switched, it's just on when the inverter's on. However, the main purpose of this outlet here, it was actually to be able to transfer power from truck to caravan. So the way that's done is obviously by turning the inverter on in here, plugging into here, running it through one of the 10 amp to 15 amp converters, so your Amphibians, there's a few other brands as well out there, and then plugging it into the inlet of the caravan, in which it'll obviously charge up and run the caravan as well. So obviously allowing extra time for running aircon, all that stuff directly off the truck. Obviously full towing setup as well to be able to tow the caravan, fairly straightforward. 24 volt Anderson for DC-DC charge, 12 volt, obviously trailer plug for trailer lights and brake safe charge, that sort of jazz. And we also have a separate 12 volt and a blue Anderson feed here purely to run their three-way fridge while driving as well. We've also got an air chuck from the ARB air compressor, which we'll show you in a second, and a separate external solar input. So like I was explaining before, the solar input side of the DC-DC just runs to an external plug. So we can, if they want even more solar, if just in case 2200 watts of solar is enough for them, they can then plug an extra couple blankets in to the outside. By far the coolest part of this build though, obviously everything else is amazing, give you the best, you know, off-grid system you can possibly get out of this thing. But what is really cool, my personal favorite, probably because I'm a guy and I like small things, is this crane. How cool? So the whole idea of this section of the Armadillo is to be able to store a bike and a trike actually in here as well. So what these customers have done, install this little 400 kilo crane, operated just by this pretty simple old up down remote, press of a button, away we go. I could play with this all day, so much fun. Okay guys, so this is, I guess, probably the main service hub, I guess you want to call it, of the system. So what we've got here and in behind here, we've got the ARB 24 volt twin cylinder compressor, and we have got an outlet each side. So we've got outlet here, now on the other side of the seat, and then that outlet at the rear I showed you before. So options of either three. Reason why I've done that, obviously the standard hose comes with the ARB compressors, a 6 metery. So you can plug it in here, service these two tires, plug it on the other side, service those two tires, or plug it into the back and service the two van tires. So, also the four van tires, I should say. So yeah, really nice and easy. So yeah, from anything from pumping up tires to pumping up your inflatable best friend you're taking your trips with you, you've got everything all sorted here. Now, control panel wise, we've got obviously the screen for the EnerDrive ePro, so this is gonna tell you exactly what's in the lithium system we've done on the back there. The reason why we haven't put the screen in the back there is obviously you're gonna be working out of the cab a lot more than we're gonna be working out of the canopy. So they've opted to have the screen in under here, along with the inverter switch here as well, being that there's a few external outlets on this, and that they're not gonna be using the outlets in that battery box very often. They opted to have the inverter screen here as well. So just a real simple one touch of the inverter screen, and then a couple seconds and everything's on 240 volt wires. So you can transfer some power through to your van, or plug in your induction cookers, whatever you like, in the back of the canopy. Have also got really basic, just a couple of 12 volt sockets, SIG, USB. And yeah, that's all for under here. As always guys, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, make sure you drop them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to shoot us a like and a subscribe. Check out some of our other wicked touring builds up here, and YouTube reckons you should watch this.